Hey everybody, and welcome to story time. I'm Pear.
And I'm Spider Orange. Whee!
Dude, would you watch where you're swinging?
Sorry, didn't mean to bug you.
Well, I'm glad to see you're excited for today's episode, Orange.
Yeah, you might say I'm really getting into the swing of things. Whee!
I take it this means you did the required reading for today's episode for once?
Nah, it was too long.
Dude, it's a comic book.
Oh, well in that case, it had too many pictures.
You didn't even open it, did you?
No need, Pear. I pretty much remember it from the first time I didn't read it as a kid.
Oh yeah? So what's the title?
The, Annoying Spider-Man.
Close, but also way off. It's The Amazing Spider-Man.
Eh. We'll see about that.
Great.
Once upon a time, there was a high school kid named Peter Parker. Now, he wasn't exactly the coolest or the biggest kid at school, but he was super good at science. How am I doing so far, Pear?
This is actually pretty spot on.
Told you I remembered it. My mind is a steel scrap.
That's not how it...
One day, Peter Parker went to a science fair, but there was no concession stand or anything, so he got super hungry. Finally, he bit into a radioactive spider.
Come again?
He bit a radioactive spider.
Okay, that's what I thought you said. See, that's not exactly...
And because the spider was radioactive, Peter Parker accrued the powers of the spider. 8 limbs, 8 eyeballs, the ability to scare people when the bathroom light comes on.
Yeah, I think we're gonna need to tap the brakes here. Dude, those aren't the superpowers he got.
Well, sure they are. True or false, Peter Parker got spider superpowers.
Sure, but not those powers. He got all the cool ones. I mean, it's not like he suddenly started eating flies or something.
That's where you're wrong, Mon Pear. He did start eating flies by the bowlful.
No, he didn't. Why would he do that? Flies are a disgusting thing to eat.
Pear, we're talking about a guy who bit a spider. You really think he's gonna be grossed out by the thought of eating a fly?
Good point.
Booyah! Now, if you don't mind, I will continue the list of spider powers that Peter Parker accrued. He grew a thorax. He lost the ability to speak. And most importantly, he gained the ability to shoot spider webbing out of his butt.
Close enough, I guess.
So he went out on the town, shooting butt webs all over the place. He wasn't great at first, but he got into the swing of things soon enough. Oh, but here's the thing. Just as he gained the powers of a spider, he also gained the downsides of being a spider.
Growing a thorax wasn't already a downside?
Of course not, Pear. The thorax is a very important body part. Plus, the ladies love it.
Good grief.
Sadly, Peter Parker got the bad spider stuff too, like the ability to be easily trapped under a water glass.
This used to be one of my favorite origin stories.
Also, he lost the ability to speak. His brain shrunk to the size of a sesame seed, and his lifespan reduced to approximately 1 to 2 years.
Dude, this is the worst superhero of all time.
What do you want from me? The guy could have bitten a radioactive Nobel Prize winner or something, but he opted for a dumb old spider. Actions have consequences, Pear. With great power comes, something, something, something.
Listen, can we just get to the part where he fights bad guys, please?
Sure thing. There were no shortage of enemies, and Peter Parker took them all on as Spider-Man. There was Lizard.
I think you mean the Lizard, right?
Nah, pretty sure it's just Lizard. Other enemies included Chickadees, Bluebird, Trout.
Hold up. These aren't Spider-Man villains. They're just...
natural predators of the spider. I know. Don't worry, Pear. I got this. Blackbird, Gecko, other spiders!
Stop! Spider-Man did not swing around the city shooting webbing from his butt battling the natural predators of the spider.
Well, sure he did, just not for very long.
Oh, and why is that? Are you gonna tell me he got defeated by Trout?
No, although Trout is a fearsome and formidable foe, Spider-Man met his match when he got trapped underneath a water glass!
Oh my gosh, a water glass? Come on, at least tell me his escape from the water glass was exciting.
Not really, he never escaped. He was under there a while and, well, you know what I was saying earlier about his severely reduced lifespan.
So, that's it? That's the entire story of the Amazing Spider-Man?
Yep.
What, may I ask, was so amazing about a so-called superhero who fought a trout, got trapped under a glass, and promptly died? How on earth did he get the title of superhero anyway?
You're right, Pear. It defies logic.
I'll say.
It's incredible.
Exactly.
One might even say it's amazing.
Oh my gosh.
The land.
It's a bird. It's a plane. It's story time. Welcome, fruit lovers. I'm Pear. And joining me today for this very super episode is Lou the Tick.
I told you not to call me by my real name. I'm pretty sure there's a bug in this room.
Dude, you are a bug in this room.
Oh, you're right. Quick, get rid of me. Hit me over the head with this mallet.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. But what I am gonna do is tell the story of the greatest superhero of all time.
The Tick.
No. Superman.
Ah, gotcha. Personally, I feel the Tick is the greatest superhero ever, but maybe I'm just biased.
Yeah, you're probably related to him or something, right?
Wow! Did you really just say that? Not all Ticks are related, Pear. Jeez!
Oh! Sorry.
But yeah, we do happen to be second cousins, thrice removed. Anyway, let's go on with the story before I get really ticked off.
All right. Once upon a time, on a faraway planet named Krypton, a baby was born and...
Hold up! Is that baby Superman? You're telling me Superman's from another planet? He's an alien?
Yeah, technically he's an alien.
Whoa, okay. You had my attention, but now you have my curiosity. Pear, why the heck did you not tell me this story was about aliens? Let me set up my wall of conspiracy really quick. I'm gonna be able to help you big time, especially with all the stuff that the government doesn't want you to know.
Great. Anyway, Superman's planet was destroyed, but his parents managed to save him just in time by sending him to Earth. When he arrived...
Everyone thought he was super weird because he was green and oozed mucus, right?
What?
Now, like most aliens, Superman probably had difficulty with the high nitrogen content of our atmospheric air, not to mention Earth's gravity and temperature level.
Lou?
I'd be curious to know, with which Arcani dialect did he communicate? And how did Earthlings deal with the fact that Superman has to poop every 7.3 seconds?
Lou, none of this is in the story.
None of it?
No, Superman isn't green. He looks exactly like a human.
What?
Yeah, he even got adopted by a human family in rural Kansas. They named him Clark Kent.
Oh, you're kidding me. Pear, this is wrong on every level.
Kansas?
No alien would ever be able to survive in such close proximity to corn! That's why they make crop circles. They're desperate to eradicate cornfields. Corn is like their kryptonite.
Yeah, actually, kryptonite is Superman's kryptonite.
Huh, you're telling me kryptonite is an actual thing? I always thought it was just like a metaphor. And also the name of my favorite Three Doors Down song.
Yes, it's a thing. And kryptonite weakens all of his superhuman abilities, like X-ray vision, super strength, impenetrable skin, and the ability to fly.
Well, it's nice to know they did at least some research on real aliens. But what about his need to poop? 7.3 seconds. How does kryptonite affect that?
It doesn't, dude.
Well, I guess that makes sense. When you gotta squeeze one, you gotta squeeze one.
No! I'm saying that isn't one of Superman's abilities. He poops the same amount as a normal human. Why are you laughing?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just so ridiculous. I've never heard a story that got basic facts about aliens this wrong before. This is the most insane story I've ever heard in my life.
Coming from you, Lou, that means a lot. Anyway, Clark Kent grew up to become a reporter in the bustling city of Metropolis, where he disguised himself in order to fight crime without being recognized.
How'd he disguise himself?
Well, when trouble arose, he'd often duck into a phone booth, remove his glasses, and emerge in his Superman suit.
Wow, would you look at that? It's a bird, it's a plane, it's obviously Clark Kent!
Huh?
I mean, come on, that's his disguise? He just took off his glasses, and suddenly everyone thought he was a totally different person?
Well, yeah, that's how the story goes.
This makes no sense. Pear, this story is so crazy, I don't have room for it all on my wall of conspiracy.
All right, I'm sorry, Lou. I guess it was a mistake to introduce you to the concept of fiction like this.
Huh, I'll say. And you want to know the most insane part of all this?
What's that?
Superman's suit. I mean, how does he use the bathroom in that thing? You're telling me he's able to constantly get that thing off and on, off and on, off and on, throughout the day, every 7.3 seconds?
Lou!
I mean, I get he's superhuman. There's some feats that are simply too impossible, even for the greatest superhero.
Lou! Superman doesn't take his suit off every 7.3 seconds.
Ew! You mean he just goes inside the suit? I thought this was for kids, Bear! What a gross, terrible story! Please, tell me that's the end.
Sure. That's probably as good of a place to stop as any. Sorry, Lou. Won't happen again.
I should hope not. Jeez Louise. Superman? More like Pooperman!
Enough, Lou!
Hey, Flubbers! And welcome to story time! I'm Orange.
And I'm Sis.
Whoa! I usually do these with Pear.
Well, apparently not today.
What happened? Did he call in sick?
Yeah, sick of you. Now, what's today's story? I totally didn't read it.
Uh-oh. Well, I didn't read it either. That's usually Pear's job. But today we're telling the story of Batman.
I don't know that story very well, but I sure do know the theme song.
Batman! Okay, here we go. Let's just bat-wing it the best we can.
Okay, so one thing I do know is that Batman's real name is Bruce Wayne.
Why does he have two first names?
I don't know. Probably the same reason his superhero name is two mammals. Anyway, what I don't remember is the name of the city he lives in. Gothic City? Gothic Bold? Century Gothic?
Pretty sure those are fonts. Ooh, Goth City?
Goth City. Yeah, that's it.
Sounds like the kind of place that has a Hot Topic on every corner.
That's exactly the kind of place it is. And one day when young Brucey McFirst Two Names and his bajillionaire parents were leaving one of Goth City's numerous Hot Topic locations, his parents got murdered.
Whoa! Who killed them?
I don't know. I'm pretty sure it was Bat, right? Batman?
Well, that almost makes too much sense. But hold on. Why were his parents so rich?
Well, you know how bat poop is, like, really expensive?
Who doesn't?
I'm pretty sure they were trafficking bat poop, and then Bat Mafia put out a hit on them.
Okay, it was kind of making sense before, but now it's making complete sense. Of course it was a bat hit. You hit things with a bat.
My mind is blown right now.
My mind is literally mush.
Let's continue.
Okay, so here's the part I'm confused about. If bats killed his parents, then why did he dress up like them all the time?
Isn't it obvious? To blend in, so we could take them out from the inside.
From the inside of what?
Probably their bat cave.
Oh, there's a term I somewhat recognize. We must be on the right track.
Okay, so Batman gained entrance to the evil bat's cave.
How'd he get in?
I don't know. He probably batarang the doorbell or something.
Nice.
But point is, he got inside, and that's when he went bat poop crazy on him. He was punching out bats every this way and that. He punched one clear through a cloud. That's why the clouds always look like that in the movies.
Ooh, did he punch one through a car? And that's why the Batmobile looks like a bat?
Orange, don't be ridiculous.
Sorry.
Anyway, after avenging his parents' death, he teamed up with Robin, whose parents were murdered by Robins.
Whoa, Robins can kill people?
They're murderous savages, Orange. How do you think their chest got so red?
Oh my goodness, I'm learning so much today. Wait, so Catwoman?
Her parents were murdered by cats.
The Penguin?
Penguins, yeah, they have really sharp beaks.
What about Mr. Freeze?
I think you already know the answer.
His family was murdered by popsicles, weren't they?
Yes.
Oh, I've never trusted popsicles, not one bit.
And so, to this day, Batman protects the citizens of Goth City from bats and robins and cats and penguins and popsicles using his massive wealth accrued from trafficking bat poop.
The end!